to provide the study of Buddhism integrated with modern science for the purpose of mental and social development. Okay. I think something I cannot. Okay. Can you? Mm-hmm. How to achieve the goal of mental and social development here by studying Buddhism integrated with modern science? It is not just for theoretical study in the classroom that you can have mental development. You have to come here and practice meditation. And what is the basis of meditation practice? The foundation. When you are meditation master, train you in meditation. They want you to be aware of the present moment. That is to cultivate mindfulness. Mindfulness is the foundation of meditation practice. You might have heard the Pali words, appamada sammosarana. Here, as the Buddha said, all kinds of Dhamma converge into the scope of heedfulness, appamada. I quote from Appamada Sutta, just as the footprints of all legged animals are encompassed by footprint of the elephant, and the elephant's footprint is reckoned the foremost among them in terms of size. What means is that all kinds of animals on land is smaller than elephant's footprints, as you can see in this picture. So in the same thing, all kinds of kusala dhamma, that is skillful qualities, small, are rooted in heedfulness, that is appamada, converge in heedfulness. And heedfulness is the foremost among them, that is heedfulness is the foundation. It's a foundation of all kinds of Dhamma practice. What is heedfulness, appamada? Is mindfulness. So from the Pali words of the Buddha, mindfulness become the foundation of all kind of practice. Without practicing mindfulness, you cannot achieve the goal of mental development. You cannot observe the precepts, 227 precepts for monks. It's not possible to observe the precepts without mindfulness. And to practice meditation, you have to cultivate mindfulness. To develop wisdom or panya, mindfulness is require. So what is mindfulness? Mindfulness is the meaning, the definition of mindfulness is the psychological process of bringing one attention to the internal and external experiences occurring in the present moment. Awareness of the present moment. Awareness of the internal experience, that is your feeling, vedana, your mental factors, that is cetasika, or your consciousness. This is internal experience occurring at the present moment, whatever in your mind. And at the same, that is in Pali, acchattangva, mahittava. Then you direct your attention to outside world. Whatever come across in front of you at the present moment, you are aware of the object of your consciousness. Become one with the object of your attention at the present moment. That is mahitta, that is external experience. So sati or mindfulness is being mindful, being aware of whatever come to your experience. My voice, my picture, my movement. At the moment, even the letters appearing on the screens become object of your attention at the present moment. You direct your attention to the object of your attention at the present moment. That is awareness. That is mindfulness. That is sati. So sati, to summarize, sati is a focus on the present moment. Try not to think about anything that went on in the past or that might be coming up in future. Atitang nanva kamaya, not to linger on the past, regretfulness about the past. No, not that. That is not your mindfulness. Not to dream about your future. Here and now, the present moment, your focus, you pay attention to. So if attention is retained continuously on one and particular object of your attention, that become the foundation of concentration or meditation. Concentration meditation is a continuous attention of particular object of thought. If you count from 1 to 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, etc., up to 100, control your mind not to wandering outside the stream of counting. Paying attention at particular number, that is number 1, number 2, number 3 in the sequence, that is mindfulness of particular number of counting. 1, 2, 3. Paying attention continuously from 1 up to 100, this continuity of your consciousness become focus. it is concentration samadhi. So sati is the foundation of samadhi. When you practice concentration meditation, it's necessary to pay attention at the present moment of your breath, of your abdomen movement, whatever. That is the meaning of mindfulness. In Pali, you can see in Visuddhimagga, the definition of sati is apilapana lakkhana. Characteristic of mindfulness is not floating. It's a kind of plunging into the object. Paying attention to the form, sound, taste, or whatever, the object of your thought at the present moment. So you just hang around there. Apilapana means to touch upon that thing, not to leave your take leave from that object of your attention. Another Pali term, or that is the meaning of when mindfulness manifests itself, its manifestation is to protect you from the attack of the outside world, to prevent your mind to wander outside. By means of awareness or sati, you guard your eye, your ear, your tongue, your nose, your body, and your mind from scattering, from wandering. And being face to face with the object of awareness, here and now, living at the present moment with the object of your attention, not to send your thoughts somewhere else. That is the meaning of awareness or sati in Visuddhimagga. So from the definition of sati or mindfulness, as I have given you, you can see that why the Buddha conclude that all kinds of dhammas, especially meritorious dhamma, kusala dhamma, all kinds of meritorious dhamma or kusala dhamma merge with mindfulness under the umbrella of mindfulness. If we want to achieve our development, human development, we have to cultivate mindfulness first. This mindfulness cultivation will bring about development of human being. As a student of MCU, you have to be developed in accordance with the 9 principles of student development. Your practice, your self-control, in such a way that as monks or lay people, you must develop self-control. มีปฏิปทาน่าเลื่อมใส behavior with good behavior as monk or Buddhist lay people to observe precept, etc. You cannot have a good manner or good behavior without mindfulness. To develop your good manner or good behavior, it is a kind of the first kind of development that is physical development in Buddhism, Kaya Bhavana. Physical development, Kaya Bhavana, is number one in Buddhist development. So MCU call it mental and social development. Actually, there are four kinds of developments in Buddhism, not just social or mental. As you can see here, all forms, all kinds of development in Buddhism are Kaya Bhavana, physical development, Sila Bhavana, social development, Chitta Bhavana, mental development, Panya Bhavana, intellectual or wisdom development. Try to understand the scope of these developments, and you will understand how mindfulness is the foundation of Buddhist development. Starting from physical development, this difficult physical development, as in MCU principle of student development, number one is mi patipatha na rum sai, to develop student to have good behavior in accordance with moral rules. For example, how we develop student in such a way, we have to observe the manner or behavior of students, whether they have self-control or not. How to have self-control? We need to develop mindfulness first. If you have self-awareness of your body, Kayanupassana, contemplation of your body, contemplation of your feeling, Vedananupassana, contemplation on your mental factor, Cetasika, contemplation of your consciousness, conscious state of mind, conscious state and on your mind, Cittanupassana, and Dhammanupassana, concentration of on your psychic state or mental states, whether it is anger, hatred, or the opposite like compassion, loving kindness. So when you are aware of your inner state of mind, you control your feeling, you control your mind. So this is a starting point of self-control. Mind control your bodily movement from your mind, your consciousness, your mindfulness control your behavior, your movement, your act. The Buddha said, Cetanahang bhikkhave kammang vadami. I said that intention is kamma. Bodily action or verbal action come from your thought. If you can control your thought by means of mindfulness, it means that you succeed in physical development. Develop physical movement so that you can perform good kamma only, not bad kamma, for the benefits of the world. This is physical development is based on mindfulness. For social development, to be possible is to observe the precept Sila Bhavana. And it is easy to understand that without mindfulness, you will fail to observe even just 5 precepts. Not to kill, not to hurt other people. That's the rule. But when you are so angry that you want to kill someone, you want to hit someone, without mindfulness to check your feeling angry, then you attack the other people verbally or physically. It's a violation of precept. To observe the precept, it means you have to develop mindfulness. Good precept that develop in your mind is Sila Bhavana. It is a social development, how to live together in society. Sila Bhavana help you to live peacefully or with other people, with animals, with environment, not to hurt other people, not to harm your natural environment. Number 3, Citta Bhavana is mental development. Develop your mind. To develop your mind means you cultivate good qualities of mind, such as metta, loving kindness, karuna, compassion. And to purify your mind of hatred or ignorance, greed, hatred, ignorance, your mental state is pure and is instead of happiness, to be happy or to have well-being of your mental state of your mind, you need mental development, citta bhavana. Right now, you are practicing meditation at Kamson. You are achieving mental development by means of meditation practice, starting from samadhi, concentration, and apply your concentration to wisdom development. Number 4, intellectual development, panya bhavana. So these 2 kinds of development, citta bhavana and panya bhavana, are based on mindfulness, sati. Without sati development, without mindfulness development, you cannot achieve citta bhavana and panya bhavana. So what I mean here is that mindfulness is the foundation for kaya bhavana, physical development, sila bhavana, social development, citta bhavana, mental development, and panya bhavana, intellectual development. So I would say that the middle part of development in Buddhism is not to go into the extreme emphasis. If you too much emphasize on physical development, and with too much emphasis on physical development or social development, not paying attention at all to mental and intellectual or wisdom development, you fall into one extreme, that is material development, become materialism. And if you neglect physical or social development, just paying attention to mental and wisdom development, you torture yourself. You tend towards another extreme, atta kila mathanuyog, self-torture. So for development to be balanced in Buddhism, you pay attention to all aspects of your life, physical, social, mental, and wisdom development, and you become the complete person. A complete person is a person who develop to have four kinds of development: kaya bhavana, sila bhavana, citta bhavana, and panya bhavana. Now you can see that not only in Buddhist community that a person has to be developed in four dimensions, or people in the world, all human beings need four kinds of development or balanced development. And the starting point of the balanced development is mindfulness. The foundation of balanced development, the middle path to development, Majjhima Paṭipadā, to development is mindfulness. So mindfulness is the foundation of all kinds of development. And the Buddha said that all good action, all good Dhamma falls under the merge or are included in the scope of mindfulness. So mindfulness is very important. Now you learn what is mindfulness, not by theoretical study alone, but by practicing, paying attention to the present moment in your mind, paying attention to the present moment outside, in the outside world. This is a mental development, and this is a mindfulness development, which is the foundation of all kinds of four kinds of development. Once we come to this point, we have to balance four kinds of development in your life, not to be incomplete like this chair. It lacks one pillar and one leg. So a person without one of the four development is just like this chair, not stable, not to be complete person. So in Buddhism, for a person to be a complete person, you have to develop your bodily factors, your social factors, social dimension, mental factors, and wisdom that is required in the modern education. In a modern form of education in the world right now, you develop only intellectual aspect of your life that is not complete. It become just number four of development, IQ. Intellectual development is just one aspect of your life. It is not sufficient for MCU to develop your intellectual aspect of your life. We have to encourage the students to develop their, not only their mental state, mental development, wisdom, physical, and social dimension of your life. So as it is clear in the Western education that the student must have a balanced development of both IQ and EQ. IQ is about the intelligence part of your life, whereas EQ is emotional intelligence. How to achieve emotional intelligence besides your IQ? They say you must cultivate awareness. Awareness of what? You can see here, EQ. in order to add the EQ aspect, emotional intelligence into your life, you have to develop this thing that is self-awareness first. You are aware of your mental state, whether you are it become a bad element in your mind, your anger, your hatred, your ignorance, your fear. Once you have awareness of your mental state, internal experience, then you have to manage your anger. I am angry right now. That is self-awareness. I have to get rid of anger. I have to control my anger, not to show to my loved one that I'm angry with him or with her. That is self-management. Not to be enslaved by your anger. This is how to have self-control, how to manage your moods. That is self-management. It shows that you have emotional intelligence by monitoring your feeling, your mental state, that is self-awareness. And then you manage to control your anger. You manage to develop loving kindness, compassion in your mind. That is self-management. It's starting from Achatta. Achatta means awareness of inner experience or internal experience in your life. This is the first part of emotional intelligence. And also, you are aware of the feeling or thinking or worry of other people. It is social awareness. It's like a metta, loving kindness, karuna, compassion, empathy. You connect yourself with other people. To live together with other people peacefully, you have to care for the feeling of other people, to act in accordance with other people's expectation. To be a good leader, you have to understand the feeling, the moods of your followers. How can you understand their feeling, your mental state, without social awareness? That is awareness of the state of my other people. If they are in bad mood, they have no self-confidence. As a leader, you want to encourage them. First, you need social awareness, awareness of other people feeling. That is mindfulness for outside external experience, external thing. Then once you are aware of other feeling, you have to manage the feeling of other people. If they hate you, don't let them hate you for a long time. Start to stop their feeling, to change their attitude towards you, to speak something out, to pacify them. That is relationship management. To live without understanding other people is a mindless people. But to have emotional intelligence, you understand the feeling, the thing, the thought of other people thinking right now, and control or manipulate them, lead them into action. That is relationship management. So in the gist of emotional intelligence is that you start with self-awareness and then move on to self-management. Develop social awareness for the purpose of social management. This is EQ, development, emotional intelligence development, that is similar to mental development in Buddhism. And the starting point of EQ in the Western psychology is mindfulness. Mindfulness is, you can see here, the foundation of EQ is mindfulness. To be aware of yourself, you need mindfulness. Mindfulness is here. To have self-awareness, you need mindfulness to be the foundation of self-awareness. Then you develop this awareness of yourself, your feeling, into what? Emotional balance, self-control, self-awareness to self-management. From self-control, you are at the same time, you develop social awareness, awareness of other people, action, other people, thought or feeling. Then you can have relationship management. So EQ, the process of EQ is possible because of mindfulness. I believe that the education practitioner or education philosopher in the West will explain and develop the EQ, provide the methodology of development of EQ easier if they apply the teaching of mindfulness into their system. And the education theorist or philosopher can develop EQ or incorporate EQ, emotional intelligence, into our system of education in the East easier if they related the concept of mindfulness to four kinds of awareness: self-awareness, self-management, social awareness, social management. EQ system is possible by means of mindfulness. So we mix the teaching of mindfulness in Buddhism with the educational theory of emotional development in the West, then it becomes perfect. Perfect educational theory, educational philosophy. You can see how mindfulness become a wisdom for the world to bring the two paths, one from the East, one from the West, to meet with each other. East meets West. Here is the concept of mindfulness. We contribute for the success of education in the West. We, the Buddhists, contribute the concept or the teaching of mindfulness to the West. That is why this Mindful School. Mindful School in the West is possible because they encourage their students to practice mindfulness. They call the movement the Mind School Movement. You can find in many states of the USA, teachers teach their students to practice mindfulness in school. The benefits benefits of mindfulness is plenty. How mindfulness is useful for children, you can see from this picture. This one says mindfulness helps to improve attention span. Mindfulness helps manage stress. Mindfulness increases sense of well-being for children. Mindfulness improves communication skills. And mindfulness helps to get stress reduction. So pupil students in the West practice meditation. This by means of mindfulness. So mindfulness now, starting from Sammasati, right? Mindfulness in Buddhism become a wisdom for the world. You can see, if you go out to preach Dhamma in the West, don't forget to teach mindfulness practice to them, for children in schools, for people, for all kinds of people on walks of life. Why? Because for the public in the West, the people in the West, they have mental stress. The stress and the problem of their mental health. So in the West, there is a movement right now called MBSR. They provide education, training, workshop for mindfulness-based stress reduction program. Yet, as you can see, the advertisement here, last year, this one. It is a MBSR program, a training on mindfulness so that to reduce stress in our mind is called mindfulness-based stress reduction. Very popular in all circles for the grown-ups in USA and in the West, especially in USA and in Europe. So the pioneer of MBSR is Dr. John Kabat-Zinn. You can see. He wrote a book on awareness or mindfulness and developed mindfulness into mindfulness-based stress reduction in 1979. Dr. John Kabat-Zinn is a pioneer and now very successful. You can see that in USA alone, there are many people, about 30,000 people have joined MBSR, mindfulness-based reduction in USA, 30,000 people. Hundreds of medical centers, university, and business offering mindfulness training to employees, physicians, students, at-risk and patients. They are not waiting for months to train them. They learn the technique of mindfulness practice and apply in daily life to train their students not to be stressful, to reduce the stressful. To heal the psychic state of mind, start by practicing awareness or mindfulness and applying it in daily life. You can see that this is the contribution of mindfulness or sati in the world. Become a light in the darkness of mind to show the way out of suffering, of many people. Mindfulness is the key term in Buddhism. Eightfold Path, that is Noble Eightfold Path, Sammasati, right mindfulness. Now you learn that how mindfulness is very important in Buddhism. It is a focal point of departure. If you want to develop yourself, you're starting practicing awareness here and now. And when you start develop yourself right now, here and now, live at the present moment. This is a starting point to be a good person, a better person, physically, socially, mentally, and intellectually. How to start? How to begin practicing meditation? By means of awareness or mindfulness or sati. And you know by yourself now, you learn by your experience that what is mindfulness by practicing meditation, by means of practicing meditation here at Campson. You learn by your own experience, internal and external. This is awareness. How awareness is our mindfulness is helpful, useful for your own development. You have to thank your professor, your teacher, your master that lead you here. Your meditation master guide you to the path of mindfulness. You are lucky enough to have this experience of practicing meditation, practicing awareness, which is the foundation of development, social, mental, and social development for your life. We are true to the MCU, the MCU philosophy to provide the study of Buddhism integrated with a modern science for the purpose of your mental and social development. We cannot achieve the purpose without meditation practice here, without getting the first-hand experience of what is mindfulness. So you have spent time together here, almost 2 weeks, to live in the precious moment, that is the present moment, and to learn from your direct experience of what is sati, mindfulness. How is this state will be beneficial for yourself and to contribute a lot to the whole world. And as we can see, the mindful schools and MBSR, that is mindfulness-based stress reduction. So this is all that I want to convey to you, that mindfulness, how mindfulness is very important, and you have to encourage yourself to practice more and more. Even after leaving this meditation retreat, continue to practice meditation, continue to develop your mindfulness. That will be for your own good, for your own social, mental and social development. With these words, I would like to congratulate you for have been practicing meditation, for developing mindfulness for many days or more to complete your retreat program at the moment. So I appreciate your joining meditation here and would like to contribute to you by giving my thought on mindfulness as wisdom of the world.
Sadhu, sadhu, sadhu. Well, on behalf of meditations, masters, administrators, lecturers, staff, and all practitioners, led by Venerable Professor Dr. Paramahansa Paramahanso, the Director of International Buddhist Study College and Peace Study in Thai program. So we are humbly thankful and appreciate for your sharing knowledge and wisdom to us tonight. Your Dhamma talk was really beneficial and inspires to practice insight meditation more effectively. And thank you so much.
Good night.
ครับในนามของผู้ปฏิบัติและก็บาอาจารย์เจ้าหน้าที่ก็ขอกราบพระคุณพระเดชพระคุณที่ได้เมตตาแสดงธรรมนะให้แก่พวกเราในฐานะลูกศิษย์ลูกหาได้มีกำลังจิตกำลังใจในการประพฤติปฏิบัติธรรมให้ก้าวหน้ายิ่งยิ่งขึ้นไปก็ขอกราบขอพระคุณพระเดชพระคุณพระพรหมบัณฑิตศาสตราจารย์ด็อกเตอร์มาณโอกาสนี้ด้วยความเคารพอย่างสูงทุกท่านเตรียมตัวกราบพระเดชพระคุณหลวงพ่อโดยพร้อมเพรียงกัน Well everyone pleaseKindly prepare yourself to pay respect to most venerable Professor Dr. Paramahansa Bandit together. Anjali Vanta Abhiva Anjali Vanta AbhivaAnjali Vanta